Hey guys, how's it going? I'm Dude Long Couch, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda, The Breath of the Wild. So, in the intervening time, guys, I have actually swapped to the Wii U Pro controller, which is much more of a traditional kind of controller. It doesn't have the tablet screen, that giant Fisher-Price tablet right in the middle. So, I think I like it a little bit more. We'll see how it goes. I don't know if this game requires a tablet for any parts of it. I really hope it doesn't. But I guess we'll find out as we keep going. While I was preparing to start recording here, I was messing around with this controller, just trying to get, you know, all the controls down. And I found out that this dude gets antsy if you swing a weapon near him. Easy there! He's just like, hey, what are you doing, pal? Come on. But he got us a quest. I think it's the first, like, real quest of this game. It's the first real gate, because apparently we're stuck up on this plateau. Which surprised the hell out of me, because this place is already freaking massive. I guess this is just one small area of the entire game, and that excites me to no end, guys. No freaking end. But it looks like we've got a bunch of douchebags over here to deal with. Okay, that dude, he kind of, that's interesting, he kind of saw me. He didn't, like, spot me outright, but he's like, hey, something fishy's going on over there. What? Why? Okay, well, they definitely saw me now. I was going to try to figure out how to go into stealth mode. I didn't actually get the control configuration on that. Actually, let me see if I can look that up real quick. Because that seems like a really useful thing to know. And it's not here under options. Ability controls, I guess that makes much more sense, doesn't it? Oh, wow, this is a... It's only showing two things right now. Backflip. Target enemy, backpedal, and jump. Yeah, I knew that one. Side hop is the same, except it depends on which way you're swinging the stick. But it doesn't tell me how to be stealthy. Oh well. We'll figure it out, guys. There's going to be a lot of trial and error in this game. For now, I'm going to try and beat the shit out of these guys. And they're going to try and beat the shit out of me. Okay. I have to be careful. I can't believe, like, how strong these bros are. Can I swap my Z target? I'm trying to, like, use the right stick to, like, flick around. That's not working. I guess you just gotta let go and then hit it again real quick. Oh, that was sick! That was sick as fuck. I'm not gonna do that in the air. Give me your stuff. Damn it! That dude is hitting me from all the way over there. Okay, I gotta go take care of him. Because that's gonna be the thing that gets me. Stop blowing your stupid horn! Jerk ass. Okay, there goes my woodcutter's axe. Let me get to some relatively safe spot here. I know that this pauses the action, but I want to be able to just, you know, get my bearings. It seems like as long as you're running, you're pretty much not gonna get hit by the arrows and the rocks that they throw. Which is real nice. You can't carry any more of those. Oh, we're maxed out on bows, guys. Alright. Well, let's use some of it up then. You guys probably already know this about me if you're familiar with my channel, but I am a big proponent of bow and arrows in video games. I love using them. So the fact that we have access to that stuff already makes me so happy in this game. Give me something good, homie. Another traveler's sword, a very common sword often kept by travelers to fend off small beasts. It's fairly durable, but a bit unreliable against monsters. I don't understand that. Unreliable against monsters. I guess that just means that it's like, it's a low-level sword, you know? It's not going to be doing crazy stuff for you. Jeez. Okay, guys, so let's check out our inventory, because there's a lot going on. We're maxed out on how many bows we can carry. I guess 4 is the limit. And then we've got 18 arrows, 5 fire arrows. I'm going to be holding on to those for a while. And we've got a couple shields. Not much in the way of armor, just our regular clothes. Hylian shrooms. These only restore half a heart. I don't know if we can cook those or not. I didn't really try. Key items. I like that they segment your inventory. Like, instead of having, like, one giant inventory that, you know, you could fill up with, like, a million shields, you can carry this many shields. But then that doesn't affect your ability to carry this many bows, and so on and so on. So here's a new thing. I think that is our objective right there. But I don't know how the swimming works in this game. I don't want to drown, but you know what? We're going to jump in with both feet, I guess. Okay, this does take stamina. That sucks. We have a little dash maneuver. That's gonna kill our stamina, though. Shit, am I actually going to drown here? I really don't want that to happen. Oh, I think I just barely made it. Not sure what happens if you drown. I guess it's just death. Let's go ahead and get our stamina back. Okay, so what's going on around this place? There's a lot of, like, oh, Oman Owl Shrine. AU, Astronomical Unit? That's what I think when I see that. Oh, we can push these around. I was gonna try and bust it open and get items, but I guess that's not how it works. Butterfly! Can I collect the butterfly? No, I cannot. You guys remember that character Agatha from Twilight Princess that was all obsessed with bugs and butterflies and shit like that? That was pretty interesting. I actually liked going around and collecting all that stuff for her quests. I love that we can climb everywhere. So there's like some goddess statues up here. I guess they're not full-on goddess statues, but they have the wings. Okay, so this would be the plateau that he spoke of. Look how freaking far this land extends. Over there, I guess, is Hyrule Castle. They told us that Calamity Ganon has been sealed in there for 100 years. I don't know what qualifies him as Calamity Ganon. I mean, it's kind of nuts that they already told us straight up, hey, Ganon's in this game. He's like the final boss, I guess. Or maybe that's something we'll do like right off the bat. Who the hell knows? Over there appears to be Death Mountain. Very regular area in Zelda. That's where the Gorons live. I want to head there like as soon as I can because I love the Gorons, guys. I love the Gorons and I love like fire areas in video games. So that place is going to be sick. I just wanted to look around up there for a second. Ooh, that poppin'. That poppin's a little rough. It's alright though. I'm probably going to be willing to forgive a lot in this game, guys. Sheik Oslate confirmed. Because, like, the overall design seems so right up my alley. Travel gate registered to map. Travel gate. Ooh, is this how we fast travel? Access granted. So is this gonna be a dungeon? Oh no, we're entering someplace serious. Serious business, guys. If your weapon is close to breaking, try throwing it at an enemy using R. It will double your damage if it hits. Yeah, so I think that happens every time you use the last hit on a weapon. I think it's always a critical, which is a cool system. To you who sets foot in this shrine, I am Oman Ao. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I offer this deal? Did it say deal? I was reading too slow. It disappeared right as I was, like, getting there. Magnesis Trial. Alright. So we're gonna have some good old-fashioned Zelda puzzling. I love it. Let's see, I don't really have any items yet. I mean, I have the bow, which I guess, okay, that counts as an item. Sure. Got a cage right here. My first thought is maybe we can shoot these things right up here. Okay, no. I don't want to waste too many arrows trying that. We can totally retrieve the arrows that we shoot. Fuck, that's awesome! Oh, that's so good! I wonder if that's like indefinite or if there's a limit to it. I don't know. There's a Sheikah symbol right there. I gotta get used to this aiming. That's the thing that sucks about playing a lot of like shooter video games is like, the controls are always calibrated differently in every game you play. Like, the sensitivity of it, you gotta get a feel for it, you know? But at least I can aim with the sticks now, not that motion control bullshit. Alright, so, can we just climb this thing? We can climb, like, almost everything in this game. Not this, though. That would be too easy, right? Gotta be honest with you guys, I'm actually not seeing a whole lot. What's this thing? Oh, this is gonna be simple, isn't it? Insert that. That opens it up. Sheik Oslate authenticated. Distilling rune. Magnesis. Manipulate metallic objects using magnetism. Grab onto metallic objects using the magnetic energy that pours forth from the magnesis rune. Objects held in the magnetic snare can be lifted up and moved freely. Rune extracted. What the hell? This is so different from any other Zelda game. Use rune. Use selected rune from your Sheik Oslate. So that was the left bumper. Wow. Look at this power we have, guys. Oh, I don't have to hold it down. I thought I was gonna have to hold it down, but I just tap the bumper and it turns it like on or off. What? What is going on? We can push and pull it. With the D-pad. Okay. So, we just wanted to move that out of the way. Damn. That seems like a really powerful ability to get right off the bat. It's gonna be very different from, like, the usual stuff of, like, shooting stuff with arrows and lighting torches on fire. Can I use it on stuff like this? Oh, that's cool. We don't have to push and pull blocks anymore, guys. We can just use this thing. That's so cool. Okay, so this one we could manipulate because it's different from the regular, like, rocky blocks. Like, it's got, like, the magnetic thing on it. So, instead of, like, trying to push that one out of the way and, like, crushing myself to death, I'm gonna stick this one right here. And then climb right over it. Oh, what is that thing? Oh, shit! Okay, well, it's not friendly, whatever it is. Alright, let's do this. Let's dance, motherfucker. What up? Okay, yeah, as long as we're strafing, we're good. One more shot ought to do it. We got an ancient screw, a screw used in ancient machinery. It's made of an unknown material, and no matter how many times it's turned, its threads never seem to show signs of wear. Hmm. What is that for? Oh, it's a building material. Okay, so it's gonna be some kind of crafting material. Alright. I didn't really recognize that enemy. I'm not sure what to call that. I think this game is gonna have a good mix of, like, traditional Zelda enemies and new stuff, too. I bet you we could pick that up. And I think I can see already we're gonna need to stick it right there and use it as a bridge. Oh. Okay. That's a cool mechanic. I thoroughly enjoy that. Not sure what that thing is up there. Let's shoot it. Nope. So by the way, guys, I don't know if this is something that you're, like, majorly concerned with as a viewer, but, to answer my question from the last video, so I have the bow equipped right now, and if I hold down right on the D-pad, that's how I get to see all the ones I have equipped. But to swap back and forth between my bow and my melee weapons without unequipping them, I actually just hit the melee attack button, which is a very simple system. I was definitely overthinking it. One of my trademark errors I make in every series I make, I overthink things and make it more complicated than it has to be. But, you know, it's good to know. And then if I have a melee weapon equipped, then I just hold down right trigger and that's how I go back to my bow. And to not fire the arrow when I'm aiming like this, I just hit the melee button. It's actually very simple, it works really well, And I'm glad I got that squared away. So, there we go, D-pad. Just move that door open. What's all this? Hold up, I gotta check the surrounding areas for, like, barrels and items. It doesn't seem like you find a ton of items just, like, out in the wild, if you'll forgive the pun. there's not, like, crates and stuff with arrows and shit like that. You gotta get everything off enemies, it seems like. You have proven to possess the resolve of a true hero. You look disgusting, whoever you are. I am Omon Owl, the creator of this trial. I am a humble monk, blessed with the sight of Goddess Hylia and dedicated to helping those who seek to defeat Ganon. With your arrival, my duty is now fulfilled. Yeah, I think I was like 100 years too late though, because you look pretty rough. In the name of Goddess Hylia, allow me to bestow this gift upon you. I like gifts. Please accept this spirit orb. Ooh, pretty. Spirit Orb, a symbol of courage given to those who have overcome the challenges of a shrine. Okay, I don't know why they always, like, prompt us to go into our inventory when we get these new items, because it doesn't actually tell us anything new. Eh, whatever. May the goddess smile upon you. Thanks. Thanks, Omon Owl. And now I'm dead, because I died 100 years ago, and stayed alive for some unspecified reason. Press ZL to quickly shift the camera behind Link. If there's an object nearby that you can focus on, the camera will target it. Yep. I guess, okay, so it is technically still Z-targeting, because they call it ZL, instead of like Z, like L-trigger. Whatever, shut up. Oh man, what was the voice I was using for him? It seems you managed to get your hands on a spirit orb. Well done! How did you know? Clairvoyance, oh-ho, or perhaps just something similar. As one gets older, it can become more difficult to see what is right before one's own eyes. Ain't that the truth? However, that which was once hidden from view can often be crystal clear. But perhaps that is not true for everyone. Oh-ho-ho! The appearance of these towers and the awakening of this shrine. It is all connected to that Sheikah slate you carry on your hip there. What do you mean? I can ask for the paraglider, please? Nah, we should get more info out of him. Ooh. It has been quite some time since I have seen that Sheikah slate. Long ago, a highly advanced tribe known as the Sheikah inhabited these lands. Yeah, I kind of gathered that from their symbol being everywhere. The great power of their wisdom saved this kingdom time and time again. But their ancient technology disappeared long ago, or so it is said. It is interesting, however, to think how something like that survived all this time hidden away in a shrine. These shrines are tucked away in numerous places all across this land. On this plateau alone, I believe there are still 3 more. Bring me the treasure from each of those shrines, and I will give you my paraglider. So I need more now? That wasn't the deal? If there's more powers like the Magnesis thing, I want them. I said treasure, but I never said there would only be 1 treasure. You sneaky bitch. Whether it's 1 treasure or 4, what's the difference for a young go-getter like yourself? Since I'm feeling generous, I will also teach you a trick for finding shrines. Okay. It's always best to survey the area by looking around from a high point. Let's see here. How about you make your way to the top of that tower again? I mean, I don't know how, but I'll do it. Wait, if I say this, maybe he'll, like, explain more. Oh ho ho! I am afraid not, but do not worry. I have another little trick to share with you for your effort. Take a look at the map on your Sheikah slate. See those blue icons? You should recognize the cave where you woke, the shrine you came from, and the tower. Yeah. Sure. You can travel instantly to any of those places with the Sheikah Slate. Nice. Or so I heard quite some time ago. I do not know if it actually works as such. Okay, so he's saying we can teleport straight to the top of that tower?
Ooh.
Try traveling to the top of the tower. From there, you should be able to scout the location of another shrine. You sure know a lot. Oh ho ho! When you have been around as long as I have, you pick up a thing or two. Go on, why not try it out? Yeah, I'm not entirely sure what this dude's deal is, but I'm pretty sure there's gonna be more to him than just a weird old man who helps us out. Like, he's gonna be like an adult version of Link from 100 years ago or some crazy shit like that. I don't know yet. Alright, so we pull this up. Shrine of Resurrection, that's where we woke up, right? That's the tower, and then that's the shrine we just did. So we can fast travel to any of these spots. That's really cool. River of the Dead. Stamp or map pin. What? Okay, we'll deal with that in a second. Let's see how this works. That was pretty. Kind of reminded me of like the way the Power Rangers teleport. Not exactly the same. Metal weapons create sparks that can be used to light a fire. Furthermore, if you set a wooden weapon on fire, it can be used as a torch. Yeah, I kind of had that happen in the first video. It was really cool. Hey, how'd you get up here? Oh ho ho. No, tell me how you did that. I'm surprised it took you so long to catch up with an old man like me. Did you fly here? Oh ho ho, so you think an old man like me needs to fly to stay ahead of you? I still have a few tricks left in me. Now then. I wanted you to join me up here so you could use this as a vantage point to search for shrines. Do you know about the scope on your Sheikah Slate? Nope. Look through it and you can stick a pin anywhere you'd like to mark on the map. So, wait. You just send things and mark them with pins. Okay, that's not... What button is that on the Wii U tablet? I'm not using the damn tablet.
Ooh.
The pins on your map serve as reference points for your travels. Just stick a pin anywhere you're interested in. How do you know? Oh ho ho! Just a few tricks I've picked up after many, many years in the wild. You may take my advice or leave it. Go ahead and take a look if you feel inclined to do so. Alright, so now I have to figure out how to do this on the Pro Controller. Oh shit, I hit the wrong button. Oh well. Oh, up on the D-pad gives me... I guess that's how we're gonna select multiple runes after we have a bunch of them. I can still whistle. I feel like I've hit every button on this controller and none of them are doing the thing I want them to do. Okay, there it is. We click down on the right stick. I forgot that this controller had the clicking functionality too. So this is how we do our first person scope around kind of view. That's really neat. Edit pins or place a pin with A. Alright, let me actually get in a spot that I want to... Oh, that's a blue one. Okay, that's probably the one we just did then. Would be my guess. Is that another one right there? Ooh. Okay. We've placed a pin on that one. And is... Okay, so it shows up on the mini-map, but not the overworld. That's good to know. I believe I spy another one right up there. That gets a blue one, so they're color-coded. And right up there appears to be... the third one? I don't know if these are all in spots that we can reach. I mean, there's a lot of shit on this map. There's a lot going on. That looks like it's maybe something over there? There's only supposed to be three more of these, but I can't really tell what that is. And I see more towers over there. I believe those are towers we're going to have to activate. Again, not sure if we can actually reach them yet. You guys know what I want to do before we, like, do any of this stuff, honestly? I kind of want to go check out the Temple of Time. Because we kind of glossed right over that. But there might be some really interesting stuff in there. And it's actually pretty close. It's right there. So, I think that's where I'm actually going to head for now. I guess we're done talking to this dude. We'll just leave him up there. We can definitely fast travel back here anytime we want if we need to talk to him again. But for now, I'm going this way. This kind of stuff is going to happen a lot, guys. Like, I don't know how thick this game is going to be with quests and whatnot. But I'm going to spend a lot of time just exploring, trying to find cool things, doing side quests. I mean, I want to do, like, everything in this game. I saw these arrows glinting on the ground. That's actually pretty sweet. There's a lot of them around here. Did we have a fight around here or something? They're actually really hard to see, like, in terms of, like, the model of the object. But there is a little glint letting me know that something was there. So we'll have to try and keep an eye out for that. Yeah, we definitely killed a bunch of bokoblins right there. The other thing is, I still haven't actually figured out how to go into stealth mode. Oh, I bet you we click the left stick. There it is. There it is, guys. That's how we creep around. Awesome. I'm getting it. I also wonder, like, how often these dudes respawn. I don't know if we just missed this guy before. There goes my branch. What else do we have? We're actually, do we want to fight with a torch? Probably not. I think we're going to keep using our weakest weapon that's not a torch. These Boko clubs seem pretty good. But yeah, I don't know. So, can I, like, bust these open? Oh, that damages the clubs. Just hitting the barrels? Damn, man. Ah! I was not prepared for that. That's funny. Alright. So, but yeah, like, I don't know. I did, like, shut down my system and turn it back on since the last time. Well, since the first video, I should say. And I don't know, like, if these dudes all respawn when you do that, or if they respawn if you get a certain distance away. I haven't got a sense for that yet. Sup, Holmes? I'm better than you. Give me that. Okay. This definitely looks like the Temple of Time. We haven't actually confirmed that yet. Oh, pots. Oh, R to throw. What? No. There we go. Okay, that's just dropping it. How the hell? Oh, do they mean... They meant the bumper. Okay, so that's a little different, but it's consistent because that's the same button we use to throw our weapon. So that's like the throw button. And I'm guessing that, like, using our weapon on these would ruin the durability too, so... That's kinda lame. Hey, we finally got some arrows out of one. That's good. Traveler's bow. A small bow used by travelers for protection. It doesn't do a lot of damage, but it can be used to attack foes from a distance. My inventory's full, no! But that's, like, better than all the bows I have right now. Okay. Can I drop this damaged one from here? I would very much like to do that. I guess we gotta go into the inventory to drop stuff. Actually, I hope we can drop stuff. I haven't really confirmed that yet. Sort. Select. Oh, there it is. Drop. Oh, and look, it stays on the, like, in the world. That's so cool. So we can drop stuff, but we can also pick it back up. We don't just lose it. That's so good, guys. I'm making it official. This game's great. I've seen all I need to see. This is a fucking awesome game. And we got a slightly better bow for coming up here, so... yeah. This game is definitely rewarding me for exploring things. That's like my favorite part of any good game is like the whole proverbial carrot on the stick thing. I think that's like, that's the key to making a game really, really great. Oh, we can pray in front of this statue. Alright, we'll do that in a second. Alright, let's see what it does. You who have conquered the shrines and claimed their spirit orbs. Oh! I was wondering what that thing was for. I can offer you great power. But you do not yet have 4 spirit orbs. Seek out the shrines scattered across Hyrule and face more challenges. Once you have claimed 4 spirit orbs, return to me. Okay. It's all starting to come together a little bit. So we're going to go do the rest of those shrines and... that will give us the 4 spirit orbs, I think, because I think we're going to get 1 for every one we do. Just like the first one we did. And then we'll be able to get some kind of power or upgrade. Awesome. Is that really, I guess that's the only purpose this place serves. So, like, in some previous games, the Temple of Time has been where you found the Master Sword, like in Ocarina of Time on the 64. But... I guess they don't want you to have that this early in the game, right? It's gotta be in this game. I mean, we know Ganon's in this game. I don't know if there's ever been a game that had Ganon in it and didn't have the Master Sword. Well, aside from the original, actually. Because the original Zelda game, Legend of Zelda, on the Nintendo, did not have the Master Sword. The best sword in that game was actually called the Magical Sword, and it was quite different. I mean, you don't know, like, story-wise what it is or why it came to be or anything. But it has a different sprite, a different design. Oh, search. Can we search these? Ancient screw. Awesome. Getting some crafting materials from these things. So I gather that these things here are called guardians. And, that's awesome. I guess they're like a big, strong enemy in the game. These ones are, like, kind of dead. I don't know what the hell happened here. They obviously did some damage to this place. I didn't realize we could search them. I should probably grab all these. Excuse me, sirs and madams, while I scrounge. Okay, we got all the ones up here, I think. Here's 2 more. Oh. I don't know what these things are used for, but when the time comes, I know I'm gonna want them. Maybe more. Hey, there's a little section down there that we haven't been in. Okay, let me look around back on this side first. Nope, don't want to go up there. This stamina meter is not very large. This is kind of killing me, only being able to run a little bit. It's not the end of the world. I'm hoping we'll be able to upgrade it. Did I get the screw from these two? I think I did. Yeah. But that's one of, like, my major complaints in a lot of open-world games is the fact that they slow you down so much and there's no, like, sprints. I know this game has fast travel, so, like, you don't need to be able to sprint everywhere. And it's gonna tie into, like, the climbing mechanics. It's gonna be, like, a puzzle unto itself, managing your stamina meter. I'm just saying I can't wait until I can get it upgraded so I can sprint for longer, because that's the kind of stuff that makes me happy. Alright. I don't feel like picking all these up. I'm just gonna smash them. Give me them arrows. How many arrows do we have right now? I don't know what the limit is. Right now we have 30. I'm hoping we can carry a lot more than that. Oh, look! I didn't even try that. We already have the charge spin attack. That's a Zelda staple right there. That's good to know. And I still do have to figure out that flurry attack that I pulled off. I'm pretty sure it was, like, timing... the dodge that I did, like a back-flipping dodge, but I don't actually know for sure. This is kind of weird how this place is, like, segmented into 2 separate buildings. I'm trying to remember all my Zelda lore, guys. So, like, in Twilight Princess, you went back to the Temple of Time, but I want to say it was, like, a different building. I think there was some kind of minor plot point in that game about how they, like, they added on to the original Temple of Time. I don't know if that's right or not. Whoa! What was that? I thought I saw something pop up on the right side of my screen. And then vanish right away. Maybe I'm seeing things, I don't know. That was really weird. Oh, look, there's another little part down here. This is actually pretty massive. Huh. Yeah, I don't know. I guess there's like the original Temple of Time, and then there's like additions that they made. I still don't even know if that's what this place is. I'm pretty sure it is. We can't pick these up and smash them. That sucks. What if I do this? Seared steak. Okay. So that's kind of a gamble. Like, you have to use up some weapon durability to break those kinds of things, but then it's like, you might get something really good out of it. Arrows, which seem not exactly hard to come by, but they're not exactly plentiful either. And then you could get something really nice. That seared steak is gonna come in handy. Headshot. He's not dead! Get out of here. And I'm guessing we probably can't recover the arrows that we actually hit them with. Because that would be OP, I think. Okay. Very good, very good. Give me those Boko clubs. Okay, I guess we're gonna head for this green one first. I think that one was actually the farthest one away, and the one that I'm not actually sure that we can reach. But I want to try. Oh, is that a boar? Can I hunt the boar? He's running away. Get back here, you sumbitch. What was that? Okay, I know I saw a critter skittering away on my right. That might be what I saw before at that little pool area. I guess hunting's gonna be a part of this game, too. Get yourself some food, you know? Okay, so that green indicator... Oh, there's the boar. Hold up. Come here, you little bitch. I can't see. Okay. Yep, he's gone. Oh, are those... Hey, there's chests on top of that thing. I don't think I can reach them yet, though. We probably need some kind of paraglider. I bet the paraglider would help us reach that. So where... Okay, it's over there. That's way past the lip of the plateau. So we'll leave that marker there, but I don't think we can actually reach that one yet. I think the other three in this direction are going to be the ones we want. Which one's closest? Let me consult the map. They're kind of all spread around. I guess the red one's the closest right now. So let's head in that direction. Hopefully we run into another boar. I want to stack up on meat. And I still can't see my health indicator, guys, so bear with me on that. We're just gonna have to use, like, the blinking feedback on my character model for me to know when I should heal myself. I tried figuring out a solution to that. I haven't been able to come up with anything yet. It's pretty lame, but it is what it is.